Scott, would you like to talk about capital projects?
Yeah. I'll split it into two pieces. The New Mexico piece looks like it's pretty much on track for capital funding. Ed and I've talked quite a bit. Ed made the submissions into the system for next year. We haven't heard much. We haven't heard anything negative about that piece. As we go to Colorado, it's a bit of a mixed piece coming out of Colorado. Because of some of the things that happened in the last year budget, we got word Friday that we're zeroed in the governor's office. And so we got to go put that all back together. So Mark and I and Ed will be on a phone call tomorrow or Monday, trying to work to put that budget piece back in. There is a second piece of Colorado where they're doing a one-time stimulus with some of their federal stimulus monies. We were encouraged to make an application for the remaining funds to get to sustainability. That would be given to us as a block grant, and we would then be able to manage it, and the expectation is we would have the money spent at the end of 2025. So it would be a one-time chunk of money for us to manage towards sustainability. We added an additional $1 million to that, specifically targeting wetland fire mitigation to try to minimize some of the fire danger along the right of way. So we can get a start on that. Colorado and New Mexico are handling their stimulus money completely different from the federal government. I think we've got a chance on the Colorado piece. The New Mexico piece was so targeted to different things that it didn't work. So, but we have an uphill battle on the base funding for the railroad out of Colorado, I think.
Yes, so we'll see how it goes. That's just because the governor's office is a critical part of the determination of what funding we get. We also get funding from the Joint Budget Committee through the legislature. So we'll keep campaigning on that side as well.
There's been a lot of personnel turnover in both History of Colorado and the governor's budget office, and that's not being helpful.
No, so then we have to go in and explain who we are and what we do and our importance to the community, in addition to how important our asset is here.
Scott, would you like to talk about anything? I know that Stassi talked about the historic cars, but are other capital projects that are underway or they're not able to right now?
We've been evaluating a lot of things. There's some deferred maintenance items that I think the railroad's got to take on. And Marvin and I have talked about how do we go do some work over at the eating house in Osier. We've got some opportunities for some private grants that should help us deal with some of that deferred maintenance. That building needs a coat of paint. We don't take care of that, we're going to end up putting siding on it. So we need to do some things like that. There's some lighting issues in the basement. There's a significant generator issue that keeps reoccurring. And Marvin has made, I don't know, many, many trips down past Albuquerque to haul generators back and forth. So that's providing power in Osier has been a real challenge, and it hasn't gotten better. So we've got to work through that to make sure we've got reliable electric service over there.
And we have funds on hand to be able to work on that?
We can go take care of that.
Okay. All right. Any questions for Scott?
I just want to follow up what Mark said about how impressed I have been in this kind of first month with the way the railroad staff have all pulled together in a really difficult time We've added some trains, like the 4th of July train, and I think anybody that happened to be standing in Chama that evening went out and cleaned that train and got it turned around, or went up to the top of the hill and decorated the pavilion and got the pavilion ready for our guests. People have pulled together throughout the entire railroad to make stuff happen and make this an enjoyable experience for people to come visit us. And I can't say enough about how much I'm thankful for everything people have done and the number of hours that people have worked.
Yeah. Well, terrific. When Norm and I spent a week here last week working on a historic car, it's we just saw the quality of the people working, making sure things were happening, and we were equally impressed with what's going on. And I look back over the last 51 years, and somehow it's happened to make it. So it continues to be somewhat of a miracle story. So, and I think part of that miracle is because of the Friends of the Cumbersan Toltec, and I'm a little biased about that, but I'd like to call on the Friends president to talk about things that are going on.